Welcome to the Maury Husseini College of Hospitality Management here at Daytona State College in beautiful Daytona Beach, Florida.
There are 10 teams, 3 dishes, and 1 hour to complete them in. The pressure is high for these talented high school chefs, but the question on everyone's mind is, whose dish will be called the most delish?
The ProStart program is run by the Florida Restaurant Lodging Association statewide. It's a high school training program for students that are interested in careers in the food service industry. All of these students are here today to showcase the skills that they've learned in their high school class and be judged by some of the industry professionals. This event is similar to the state competition, which will be held in March at the Orange County Convention Center, where we'll have over 62 high schools competing in 4 different events, with the culinary competition being one of the 4 events, as well as the management competition that's taking place today.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Daytona State College. On behalf of the president of this college and the board of trustees, I'm excited to see all of these fine young people here today competing. I see there's a lot of pressure. Just relax and do your thing. I've been listening in the background. You've had a lot of practice. Just do what you've been practicing, and you'll all be in good shape. So best of luck to all of you today. Let the competitions begin.
This is an offshoot of the ProStart state competition. ProStart is a program that was started by the National Restaurant Association, which really highlights restaurants and hotels and this type of thing. And they had competitions every year. Well, my people here, we used to judge it every year. And we said, well, you know what? We could do our own competition here at the college because of this great facility that we have. The judges are staff members here at the college. They're all qualified chefs. I bring only people from industry. Say, well, why are you doing that? Well, if you want a student to be judged about culinary, I think it's unfair to say, well, I got a math teacher that's gonna come here and taste your chicken, okay? Because they wanna look at how it's done. So my judges have to judge every dish that comes down. They don't switch off. So all of my staff are all industry people. Of course, they have their master's degree so they can teach here at the college. I also have invited chefs from the community. I have the chef here today from the resort and spa. He's the executive chef. He happens to be a graduate of our program, which is kind of exciting. And we have the executive chef from Halifax Hospital. So we bring in other chefs too when they're not busy to be part of our team. And what we do is we have a whole criteria. They have to be judged on their knife skills, the proper way to hold a knife, how to cut things, sanitation, proper cooking skills. Are they using the right pans for what they're supposed to cook with? There's a whole lot goes into that. And that's taught at the high schools. So they take those skills, they bring them here, and then we talk to them a little bit about that. And sometimes I say, well, you know, maybe you should hold your knife this way or try this technique. And when they leave here, we feel that we get a lot of positive comments from the students talking about how, gee, I really learned a lot about that. So we're excited. We're going to do that every year.
Team 1, Mainland High School. For an appetizer, Team 1 is serving seared sea scallops with jalapeno vinaigrette. Their entree is a lemon capered chicken with tomato sauce, mushroom couscous, and zucchini. For dessert, they are serving key lime tart with coconut whipped cream and raspberry coulis. So how did you guys prepare for this competition today?
A lot of cooking within the classroom, and that's literally about it. I mean, just a lot of searching online, seeing what we could do for like plating ideas, and then also seeing what we can do for just dishes in general. And then once we got our dishes down, then we came into the classroom and we set up in our L formation, got our burners out, and we just went to work.
So practice makes perfect then?
Hopefully. We'll see you today.
Yeah, hopefully. What goes into knife skills judging? It's more than just making sure people don't cut their fingers off, right?
A lot more than that, yeah. Each team has to produce 4 different knife skills. The 2 team members will do 2 cuts each. And what I look for mostly is not just the finished product, but how they got there. So they have to have a proper grip on the knife. They have to do the method of cutting as closely as we would teach it. And that'll lead them to a good finished product, hopefully. A lot of it too is their organization. They have to have a nice, neat, and organized setup. They have to be able to work cleanly and efficiently without clutter. And they have to also work safely. So they're not cross-contaminating from one piece to another. They have to separate their chicken from what they're cutting with their vegetables. So there's a lot to it. It's not just, you know, hoping for the best. They have to plan for it, and they have to prepare and do it correctly.
Team 2, Seabreeze High School. For starters, Team 2 will be making a classic steam bun. This is a Chinese steam bun filled with chicken thigh, shiitake mushrooms, and red bell peppers, served over a salad of fresh vegetables and herbs with a duo of sauces. Their entree is a pan-seared roulade of chicken breast, stuffed with asparagus, red bell pepper, and creamy feta cheese, with a side of turned vegetables, topped with pan sauce, served with a spicy sambal. For dessert, they are serving spiced poached pear and dark chocolate mousse. This is pear and strawberry chutney, topped with creme anglaise.
And thank you for taking the time to speak with me today.
Hi.
How did you decide on this menu?
Well, we sort of went around our head chef's competition tryout menu. She had the traditional steam bun, and we liked the flavors, all the different feelings of it. So we tried to go around a little bit around that.
Do you think today's competition is good preparation for the real world, being a chef out there?
Definitely in the real world. Most of us here want to be chefs when we're older. Definitely this competition is getting us ready for the big one, and we definitely want to do good there. So we're very appreciative of everything.
Team 3, Dunellen High School. For an appetizer, Dunellen is serving their famous Dunellen High School Jumbo Shrimp Skewers. Their entree is a filet mignon topped with Monterey mushroom along with a crispy rice patty. Their dessert is a combination of vanilla and chocolate sauce topped with a fruit medley.
And competitions like this rely heavily on teamwork. How do you think your team is dealing with the pressure?
I think we're pretty laid back. We have an idea of what we're gonna want, and we have a view of how we're gonna do it. So we're working, getting things done.
How did you guys decide on a menu?
Well, we were thinking Asian inspired, and well, Juan, he used to work at one of an Asian restaurant, so he had a lot of ideas incorporated into that, so we just went with it.
I'm here with Chef Scott, and he's a judge for team organization and management. What goes into judging something like that?
Well, they have to be organized. They have to be time managed with the hour that they have to cook, and also communicate with one another to make sure their dishes come out on time.
Team 4, Daytona High School. For starters, Daytona is serving an island citrus salad. Their entree is a sweet Caribbean lemon chicken with a savory vegetable melange. And for dessert, they are serving banana raspberry dream.
And I hear this is your first competition. How does it feel?
Nerve-wracking. Yeah, very nerve-wracking. Just trying to get everything in order and just trying not to make mistakes, you know? Yeah.
And how long did you practice for this competition?
Every day in class. Yes, we have culinary class, so every day. And sometimes even after school. Yeah.
So how did you guys decide on a menu?
It was like spontaneously out of nowhere. You know, we had a conversation with our teacher, and our teacher said one thing, and then I said another, and it just collaborated together.
Well, we're about halfway through our competition. Do you have any words of encouragement for your teammates?
Happy places, happy faces. That's it.
Well, you guys are doing a great job, and good luck.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Each team must create 3 courses and then take them to the judges' tent behind me for tasting. The start times were staggered in order for the team's creations to receive the judges' full and immediate attention.
Well, what we're going to look for is how the plate is put together. It's often said that we eat with our eyes. So with that in mind, we're going to look and see how the plate looks and is it going to be palatable, okay? When we look at the plate, we're going to see if the colors are nice. You know, are they cohesive? Is it all browns would be not so good. We want to see some vibrant colors mixed with some muted colors. We want to make sure that the cuts that they're using are really nice, so that way they're appealing to you. You want to pick it up and you want to bite into it. And then what we'll do is judge it on a scale of 1 to 5, with 5 being the best. And if it's a 5, it's like, oh, you know, we're hungry. We want to dive into that. Every bite is going to be delicious. And the students will then have some critique that will follow with that, and we'll tell them how they'll be able to make that plate look a lot better, so that way we're happy with it. Hope that helps.
So it needs to look yummy enough to eat.
Yummy enough to eat. Absolutely.
Team 5, Matanzas High School. For an appetizer, Team 5 is serving mahi-mahi fish cakes with aioli sauce. Their entree is a filet mignon with harissa-style relish, butternut squash, mashed potatoes, and crisp grilled asparagus. For dessert, they are serving strawberry divine. This is strawberry and white chocolate cheesecake mousse on a fluffy pastry and whipped cream.
What will you be preparing today?
We have a blend of European and Middle Eastern flavors.
How often did you guys practice for this competition?
Multiple times. We spent weekends going to school and practicing constantly. Even after school, we would go to our culinary room and we would practice, you know, look up recipes.
So it takes a lot of time and dedication to be a chef then?
Oh, most definitely. It is not for the faint of heart, I can promise you that.
Well, thank you very much for taking the time.
Team 6, Flagler Palm Coast High School. For an appetizer, Team 6 is serving coconut fried shrimp, served with spicy marmalade dipping sauce. The entree is sirloin tri-tip steak with tarragon melting sauce, served with green onion and garlic mashed potatoes, sauteed vegetable medley, yellow and green squash with red pepper, onion, garlic, and tomatoes. Dessert is a triple berry dumpling delight, served with vanilla bean whipped cream. I'm wondering, how did you decide on a menu for this competition?
It took about a month. We actually had our whole class go on the internet and find recipes and stuff, and we tried a lot of things before we came down to what we're doing today. Just a lot of research, I guess, figuring out what we wanted to cook.
Do you think a competition like this prepares you for the next level?
Yes. I like to cook, and I like feeling under pressure like this. It's kind of fun, I guess, so.
What goes into judging a presentation of a plate?
Well, we're looking for creativity, the challenges of the dish itself, and also the color, the texture, all that stuff that's in there. Make sure it's not too saucy, and just enough. You know, just something that you would eat with your eyes first, I guess. That's what we're looking for.
How do you think this competition or competitions like it prepare students for a real world environment?
Well, obviously our young is always the future for all of us, and if they have this behind them, they can go to the real world and use this pressure of this competition for the real world. So I think it does a lot for them, a lot for them.
Team 7, Winter Springs High School. Team 7's appetizer is a croquet madam, served with seared tuna and prosciutto ham and topped with a grape sauce. The entree is seared lamb chops marinated in chimichurri sauce, served with potatoes and steamed vegetables. For dessert, they are serving a chocolate raspberry crepe. This is a chocolate crepe stuffed with ricotta cheese and chocolate chips, served with a raspberry sauce.
And as this competition starts winding down, I'm getting really hungry. What are you preparing for us today?
Right now, I am frenching lamb for our lamb chop dish, and this will be served with potatoes and steamed vegetables.
Competition relies heavily on teamwork. How do you think your team's handling the pressure?
Well, there's definitely a lot of pressure, but we're gonna do our best to just work together and make our way through it.
Do you think competitions like this prepare you for the real world of being a chef?
Oh, definitely. There's a lot of pressure in any real world situation like this, so it's definitely good to have these skills under your belt.
Well, good luck in the competition.
One of the exciting things for the students here and ourselves is the fact that the students have to do all the cooking, all the preparation, and they actually have to come in and set up the cooking area. Now, instructors are not allowed in the cooking area, and it's an automatic disqualification if an instructor outside the cooking area says, do this, do that, and they all know that. So they all, if you go back and you watch the crowd, they're back there nervous, sitting around. I had several come up to me today, walking around. So are you doing okay? Oh, I can't stand this. I'm sitting there watching my team, you know, but that's part of the rules, because I feel that it would be unfair if a team is working and someone that's an instructor says, you know, well, they're not cutting that probably. John, don't do that. That's automatic disqualification.
Team 8, Bayside High School. Bayside's appetizer is a creamy potato leek soup. For an entree, they have sautéed chicken breast with shallots, mushroom and balsamic reduction, served with jasmine white rice and julienne carrots. For dessert, they are serving cream cheese creme brulee.
I'm here with Bayside High School, and they drove all the way from Palm Bay to be in this competition. How did you prepare for a competition like this?
We've been practicing. We started practicing in November, which is kind of a little bit late, but we've been starting to practice and every day and just getting ready for today and states.
What do you consider the most difficult part of the competition?
I think it's just like the pressure and everyone working together and make sure you don't want to get messed up or in front of anyone. So I think that's the hardest part for me.
So teamwork is very important.
Yeah. Communication. Teamwork, it's very important in the kitchen.
I'm here with Chef Mike, and I'm wondering, what sort of attributes are you looking for when judging tasting?
Well, we're looking for creativity. We're looking for how the flavors come together. Does the sauce complement the meats? How is it cooked correctly? Is the texture, taste, crunchy, sweet, salty, all that stuff. So we're looking for, is it a complete dish? Is it something that you would serve in your own restaurant?
Team 9. New Smyrna Beach High School. Team 9's appetizer is fried chicken liver salad with pickled onion and ranch dressing. The entree is golden tile fish with cheesy polenta and fried green tomatoes. For dessert, they are serving Strawberry Tower. This is fresh strawberries and whipped cream topping over a whole wheat cake.
What are you creating today?
It's a honey whipped cream.
Well, that looks really yummy and delicious. With a competition like this, there's a lot of emphasis on teamwork. How do you think your team is doing with the pressure?
I think we're doing pretty good. We all like trade off jobs. Like if somebody gets tired whisking or whatever, then we trade. If somebody needs help, then we can stop and help them. I think we're doing pretty good.
We're here with Chef Kathy, and she's judging pastry today. So you got the yummy job.
Of course I do. Yeah.
So what are you looking for in a good pastry?
Appearance. It's got to look good. We always eat with our eyes first, so that's kind of one of the things that we look for. And then secondly, of course, the taste. It's got to taste good. So we just look to see if the colors balance well, if everything is sized right, and things like that.
Team 10, South Lake High School. Team 10's appetizer is fresh spinach salad with dried cranberries and crumbled cheese. For an entree, they are serving pan-seared tuna with coconut rice and asparagus. And for dessert, pear turnovers with a caramel glaze.
So you guys traveled all the way from Lake County to be here today. Yeah. So what are you preparing for us?
Preparing coconut rice with tuna and asparagus.
How do you prepare for a competition like this?
Just a lot of time, preparation, and a lot of practice at home on your own time to make sure you have your dishes, measurements, and everything down packed, and that you're not coming out here first day, you know, not knowing what to do.
Do you have any words of encouragement for your teammates?
Just work hard. It's what we came for.
All right, thank you very much and good luck.
Thank you so much.
The clock is winding down and the teams are really feeling the heat now. And I'm getting hungry. We're here with one of the judges and the moderator for the Knowledge Bowl. Can you guys tell me what goes into creating something like this for this competition?
Well, basically what we do is we use the questions that are used from the National Pro Start Competition, and those questions will ask students things in everything from culinary science and arts, and also lodging management, accounting, travel and tourism, hospitality management, event management, and so they really have to be proficient in a lot of these different topics in order to be successful in the Knowledge Bowl. And so we put all those questions together, and each team from the schools have four participants, and they compete in a head-to-head competition that's always kind of fun.
We work around the students inside and out. Inside, we try to teach them the intangible characteristics, heart, work ethic, character. To me, more importantly, determination now more than ever before. Have that self-sacrifice about putting in volunteer time along with work experience. Combine that with your education. Then we work in on the outside as well. We put them in these scenarios where pressure is involved, where competition is involved. We got to get themselves ready for not only now, but in the workforce when they get things competitive. We do our best to set them up for success, let them know this is how it's going to be now and in the real world.
I'm here with family and friends of our talented contestants. And after all the hours of hard work, it all comes down to this moment. And everyone's excited to see whose dish will be called the most delish.
Good afternoon. I'm Laura Rumer with the Florida Restaurant and Lodging Association, and I work with all the Pro Start programs around the state. We actually owe a big thank you to Chef and his staff here at Daytona State College for putting this event on. I know it took a lot of time and effort on their part. If you get a moment and you haven't already done so, please take the time to tour their facilities back here and check out what Daytona State College has to offer. But I think really, what you really want to know are the results, so I'll let Chef get back to that.
The Knowledge Bowl. The second place winner in the Knowledge Bowl was Seabreeze High School. And they will win a $250 scholarship to Daytona State College. All right, let's begin with the winner of the Knowledge Bowl. This year is Mainland High School. And they'll take home a check of $500 scholarship to Daytona State College. All right, here we go. Culinary. Interesting. We had a tie for third place. So we are giving out two awards for third place. Okay, the third place winners were Mainland High School and New Smyrna Beach High School. Second place winner, Winter Springs. Okay, here it comes. Do I get a drum roll, a scream, a yell, something? First place winner for the Pro Start Style competition here at Daytona State College is Seabreeze High School.
been a fast-paced and exciting day for everyone here. All of the hard work has paid off. Congratulations to all of the contestants that competed here today. Your dishes looked amazing. For the Maury Husseini College of Hospitality Management here at Daytona State College, I'm April Brunning. Thanks for watching.